I've got a heavy duty aluminium fly screen and a pack of spline. So that's the spline there, that's what keeps the fly wire screen in place. Okay, so now time to do the fly wire on the screen. It's not going to be easy. It's a metal wire, and I've got this fairly old, worn out wheel to attach the fly wire. The fly wire's got plenty of width, but it's only 2.05 meters long, so I'm just going to have enough to go from here to the top. And I've got 6.5 meters of spline. I've got some spray, oil spray, and I'm thinking that's going to help with putting the edges in. Okay, I've wiped any excess oil off the frame. This was rolled up, and I rolled it up the opposite way to be able to make it flat, the fly screen. I'm going to use a clamp to clamp the opposite side of the screen so the fly wire doesn't move. Okay, so this is important. When you're putting pressure, putting fly wire screen in, the frame tends to come together. So I've got this spacer here, and I'm just going to drop it in there. It's the same width as this part, just to stop the frame from bowing. So I've got one there, and there. So now I'm going to attempt to crease the fly wire into the groove there. Make sure that the frame is straight by measuring from each corner to corner. So here I've got 2.95 meters, and just the other way I've got 2.95 meters. So that's the square. Just gently work the fly wire screen into the groove. And the fly wire tends to rise just at this point here. It's a good idea just to flatten it off. Don't forget to trim the edges. Just cut across. Stop it from buckling. Okay, all the flywire screen's in place. Now all that's left is just to trim off the excess here. I've got a knife, and I'm just going to run it across the back. Okay, that's it. Now to put on the wheels.